has a knowledge and an understanding of position from a lifetime of just all grappling, judo, wrestling, sambo. He does it all, and he has just so many ways to get you to the floor. This guy once told me that if he can get your leg, he's going to finish.
Right.
Because he's going to give you so many things to think about, you will not be able to process and keep up with him, and eventually you're on the mat. It's unbelievable to watch him apply that knowledge to the mixed martial arts fights.
And as the wrestlers say, this is not a guy you want anywhere near your bracket.
No, you don't want him in the bracket.
Well, DC, this is a true mixed martial artist of the highest order. You've watched the film. Hard for me to see much in terms of glaring weaknesses, and he believes he can react to anything that is thrown his way inside that octagon.
It's unbelievable, because whenever you're trying to prepare for someone, you look for weaknesses. But when you watch this guy, nothing jumps off the page. When you think I have to go wrestle him, you realize very quickly that not only can he defend takedowns, he can also go and secure them himself.
Sure.
He's that new breed of fighter that has been doing every discipline from the very start of his career. You know you're looking at a guy that will contend for a championship.
And if our fighter meeting on Thursday is any indication, confidence, not an issue for this young man coming in here tonight. Our tail of the tape for this highly anticipated welterweight fight. More than a decade separates these two fighters when it comes to the age, with some differences in height, but big differences in reach. All right, just about ready to go here now for the particulars. We go inside the octagon. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 6'3" tall, weighing in at 162 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, Jason! Fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 17 wins, 6 losses. He stands 5'11" tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Paul the Irish Dragon Felder. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta, your referee.
You ready? All right, you ready?
Round one is upon us between two of the best fighters in this division. Hard to find anything resembling a glaring weakness on either side when you break down the film.
There are no weaknesses in these guys. These guys are as well-rounded as they come. They both can wrestle, both can grapple, both can strike. They can do it all. And these are the matchups that we dream of as MMA fans.
Well, he's got the reach advantage. You might as well use it. Nice job there to find a home for that jab. Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots.
Ooh, what a punch.
Let's get some offense. Let's get some...
Nice body kick.
Oh, how about this kicking game on full display?
He hurt him.
Oh, huge kick to the head. Trying to stay in this fight.
Way to hide that leg kick.
Oh, good kicks there. Wow.
I mean, he's cutting them down to size with these beautiful leg kicks.
Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Oh!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh, he might be out. Both of these guys going all out. High action fight here. Felder stuffs it out.
Nice head kick.
Oh, man, how many head kicks can one man absorb before getting separated from his conscience?
One, normally. This guy has a great chin, but if he takes any more, he's going to be sleeping. Big punch lands over the top. How's he going to follow this one?
So there it is, taller fighter landing a knee to the body. And he gets it. Oh, looks like he's transitioning to an armbar.
You cannot stay in the guard of these great jiu-jitsu guys. Gotta be careful, armbar.
up here staying busy off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom. Good solid strike on the ground. All right, so he's sort of turtled up here. Not great body language. Perhaps he's trying to bait him in a little bit. A lot of top pressure being applied here. Oh, really nice work to keep busy off of his back as he lands some more offense here from bottom. So 3 minutes off the clock in our first round. Oh, now trying to isolate an arm, DC.
He needs to move his hips back to cover. He cannot allow him on that angle. He's going to tag armbar here.
Nicely done. Back to the feet now. So 39 total strikes and counting have landed for Paul Felt. Oh, knee to the head.
Good punch.
Oh, how many knees can one man take? All right, so another swing and a miss, and I'd imagine if your gas tank is this low, you gotta find times to try to preserve that energy and get yourself back to a place where you can actually dole out some damage.
Yeah, you gotta get out in space, find places to rest and recover. Get against the octagon, go to the clinch, find ways to just recover so that when you have that next explosion, it...
Nice double leg takedown attempt there, and you gotta think that's something that's gonna give him confidence moving forward in this fight.
A lot of confidence when it happens that easily. He took a shot, he got a takedown. What now will stop him from doing it over and over again?
Oh, really using his reach advantage there as he lands the punch, DC.
Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range. Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now. Oh. Ah, that jab hurt him.
Timing his shots pretty well here early, DC.
He's doing a great job of mixing things up, keeping busy, being very accurate.
Oh, massive knee to the head. We'll see if he can follow up. Both guys landing with conviction now.
So far.
All right, so let us now check out some of the action in that round, DC. There was a whole lot of it, including a stunner upstairs that nearly closed the show.
It was a lot of action. It was back and forth action, but the big moment was that big strike to the head that landed that put him on wobbly legs and in survival mode. Luckily, he made it to the end of that round.
Okay, you ready? Round two. Ready?
All right, round two.
Ooh, head kick lands, just hurt. I can't believe he's still standing after taking another massive head kick.
Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish. And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if he can follow it up.
He's landed that punch over and over again. What's he going to do to follow up?
Good series of kicks by him. Right up the gut. I'm not sure his opponent knows where he is.
No, he doesn't know where he is. He's hurt real bad. That punch landed in the perfect spot.
All right, well, he's landed some good shots tonight, but there's no three-piece. There's no soda. More often than not, it's one and done.
He's not even getting a combination. I mean, if you're going to sit there at the drive-thru, order a combination, take the soda with your food, give him the right hand behind
him.
He needs to start looking at the finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, big left hook there. Felder's got his arm under the chin, going for a guillotine now. Nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's going to start looking to land big shots from the top. He's going to start looking to try to attack a rear naked choke, and that's exactly what he's doing.
might get a finish here.
And he's out. Oh, he gets up. The question is for how long? So 65 total strikes have now landed for the iron lung, Paul Felder. Landing with 41% accuracy tonight against Paul Felder. Oh, now he's got the tie plum, Daniel. If you're on the other side, what are you trying to do to get out of this potentially dangerous position?
You got to start digging your shoulder to a side and trying to shove an underhook. You cannot bend down to try to get out of Muay Thai clinch.
Well, the octagon, not a great place to be when you're looking for a rest or a stool. His stamina has been a huge issue tonight.
It's abandoned him, but he did it. He tried. He fought as hard as he could for as long as he could. Now it's about survival mode.
Oh, big strike lands.
Big strike lands. Now he looks to try to chase down that finish.
Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. How about the speed on that reversal there? I mean, I know you can get out of some bad spots, but not with that type of speed.
You cannot allow him to get leverage on the bottom. What a sweep. Now he'll try to start attacking a rear naked choke from the top position. He is doing a really good job of relaxing, not panicking because he's getting choked. He takes his opponent to his side to try to get the finish.
Looks like his opponent's trying to turn into the choke here.
He's
a lot of pressure. Well, you got to be working off of your back. He's certainly doing so here. Nice punch. Looking for a guillotine.
A guillotine. Why is he not recognizing this right now? He's got to recognize this is dangerous. This is a dangerous position.
And this might just be a matter of time. Great job executing the submission in that fight. Really strong work. You can see the years of repetitions in the gym to set it up and ultimately get the tap there. Great technique to set up the finish. Let's take a look back at the replay as he gets it done by submission tonight, champ.
Just watch how slowly he approaches the submission, though. He never rushes. He takes his time, but it's his trickiness. It's his ability to trick people into going to the floor with him that puts them in danger and finishing fights.
So a seminal moment for this fighter here tonight as he gets the win by submission. Huge victory in his career, and it'll be very interesting to see how they matchmake him moving forward.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop. At 4 minutes, 5 seconds of round one, declaring the winner by guillotine choke, Paul the Irish Dragon Felder.
All right, so what